This is Living Dead Gal here, and welcome back to another Sims 4 Realistic Townie Makeover. If you are new, welcome to my channel. So today, the next townie that we are making over to have more of like a realistic look is yet, ironically, another occult member, Simeon Silver Sweater. So he's another sage. Last week I did Elphaba, I had a lot of fun with her, so I'm kind of continuing on with the Realm of Magic characters. We're starting with the sages, and then we'll kind of go into the, like, townies that live in the neighborhood. So, Simeon is next up. I really was, like, struggling at first with him because I was having a hard time picking out some skin details for him that I thought would work, because one thing that I wanted to keep with Simeon is, like, I wanted to keep the figure that he had. I didn't really make any tweaks to his body. The only thing I did was just fix his slouch, which I do that for all of the Sims. But I wanted to find a skin detail that made him look like a little bit more aged, just because he is another virtuoso. I believe he's like the sage of practical magic, so he just seems a little bit like older to me, because he is actually an adult. He's not a young adult like a lot of the other like pre-mades that we get are. So even though like I still kind of imagine, you know, that he's a spellcaster, he can kind of like slow down the aging process, I still think he's like a little bit older, a little bit wiser than a lot of the others, and so I wanted him to have like a little bit more of an age look and not such a fresh face. And that was another thing that was important to me, to kind of keep his body where it was. He's got like a little bit of a pot belly, and I mean, that is absolutely, I'm not talking about anyone's body image in that way. I myself have issues, but my idea is that I wanted to keep that representation there for him. You know, I didn't want to just like make him thin and buff. You know, with Vlad, yeah, I like made him more of like a hunky kind of guy, and that was sort of my plan. But with Simeon, I did want to kind of keep that representation and kind of keep, you know, when you get to be like in your middle age, I mean, I'm still in my 30s, but like I definitely feel it as I age, like the changes in my body. And so I feel like him being an adult and kind of having this body type, it really made sense. And I liked that the Sims team did that. So I really didn't want to touch that about him. So in finding skin details for him, it was kind of a struggle because I wanted something that made him look more aged but didn't give him like a six pack and a V cut. So the skin that I ended up picking for him, he does kind of have that definition, but with like the body hair and everything that I put on him, it kind of like covers it a little bit, and he can still be defined, you know, and still have that muscle definition. But I didn't want to like change his appearance so drastically in that way, because I liked the representation that we got with him for as far as a different body type, which was the same with Elphaba. I had that same thing when I was working on her, and that's something that I really liked about him. And so as I was working on him and kind of picking out like his hair and his style and everything, I gave him a little bit of a beard, a little bit of scruff. I know the original doesn't have that, but it just seemed to suit him because, again, I was going for like a little bit more of an aged, like rugged look. And for his hair, I really wanted to find like an alpha ponytail, kind of like what he has, but I ended up just loving this particular hair on him, and I felt like it worked because it definitely looks like something like a spellcaster or a magician, or like an elf, you know, would have. And it definitely fits into sort of that fantasy realm. And I also figured, you know, he does have longer hair if he pulls it back in a ponytail, so I thought that this worked. And I like it has like the two strands in the front, and so does his ponytail from the game. So that was why I chose this hair for him, and I ended up really liking it on him, and I really liked his look. And I was looking at his traits, and he doesn't have the best set of traits. He's a snob, which is not the greatest trait, but he's also a geek and he's gloomy, so he's got some dimension to him. And I think he's kind of a fun character, and I just imagine him having like a tiny, tiny little bit of sass. And so in styling him, I was kind of struggling if I wanted to go like a little bit more old school magician look, or if I, like, you know, sorcerer type of look, or if I wanted to do something a little bit more modern. And I kind of, like, I tested out a bunch of different tops on him, and I even get to one where there's, like, a suit jacket where it's, like, open a lot, and I was like, oh, I feel like he would totally rock that, you know? He doesn't care that he doesn't have, like, you know, this giant, like, six-pack abs. Like, he would totally rock the suit. That's what he's wearing right now. So I really wanted to put that on him, but then I was like, let me just look and see if I can find something that looks a little bit more sorcerer. And I ended up finding a shirt that I really liked, and that I kind of compared it to what he's wearing in the, like, Maxis version, and I was like, you know what, like this top right here, it feels super magical, and it's, like, more of, like, a tighter fit top, which he kind of has something tighter fit on, so it's kind of referencing, like, the pants and the boots that he has on in his normal everyday, and I was just trying to, like, kind of give him a more updated look based on that. So I ended up really liking this shirt because it comes with, like, medallion around the neck and all of that stuff. And I just thought that it looked like he looks like a warlock, you know, it just looked really cool. And I thought it fit with his hair. So at this point, I was, like, feeling really good about him, and I was having a blast styling him. And it made me like his character a lot more, because a lot of times, like, in my game, he's not very nice to my Sims. And so, you know, I was, like, a little bit nervous about doing this makeover because I knew that I wanted to make some bold choices with him, and I'm a little worried about how it might be received, because I know I, like, definitely made some bold choices, but I really, really wanted him to have that spellcaster vibe, and I wanted him to be a sim that I could enjoy a little bit more in my game, because normally he's, like, the snobby trait, I think, kind of takes over, and so I wanted to, you know, kind of appeal to some other sides of him and, like, make him look like he's, like, maybe been through some things, and that's why he's got that gloomy trait, like, he's got a past. And also, just, I really wanted him to look more magical. I think his attire, his everyday attire in his normal look is, you know, he looks like a modern magician, but it's just, it's very modern, and I just wanted something that was a little bit more of a callback. The same thing that I did with Elphaba, where I kind of gave her more of, like, a witchy vibe. I wanted to give him more of, like, a sorcerer type of vibe. And I just had a lot of fun picking out clothes for him. Honestly, like, I probably, if I had had, like, more time to record, I would have ended up making more outfits for him, because I found a lot of clothes that I really, really liked on him. And I just had a lot of fun with him, you know? I imagine him being, like, when he was in his early 20s, like, he probably was, like, a big lady chaser. I mean, I know that his traits are gloomy and, like, snobby and that he's a geek, but I don't know, just something about him. I feel like he definitely, like, had a lot of women that were after him, maybe even some men back in the day. And, you know, now he's kind of in his, like, middle age, like, getting, you know, looking maybe to settle down, kind of become a dad, that kind of thing. Those are just the vibes I got from him. There's not a whole lot of lore on him, same with Elphaba, so, I mean, I really pretty much, when I did my research, it was the same information that I know about all the sages. This outfit here, this sleep outfit, I know I went a little crazy with that, but I just felt like, kind of going with what I said, I feel like he probably used to be a ladies' man, so now, like, that's totally what he wears to bed. I don't know. This is just a story that I made up for him in my head, because, again, we don't really know a lot about Simeon, and he's usually just such a jerk to my sim, so I wanted to kind of give him some backstory of my own, so that when I play with him in my save, I have a little bit more fun. And for his party look, just, you know, again, I wanted to give him, like, a little more sass, like, some things that were, like, bold choices, but that felt, you know, they still felt like sorcerer, magician kind of bold. And I end up cracking up because his swimwear, for some reason, I don't know, he looks like an old, like, retired rock star to me with just, like, the swim shorts and the necklace. But I dig it. I don't know. It works. And yeah, so we're getting, like, close to the end of the video. I've been rambling a little bit, but I really, really did have a good time with him. I hope you guys like his look. I know it's, like, really, really different and really, like, drastic and, like, very bold, loud choices, but I really like doing that with my Sims. So, I hope you enjoy it. I hope you like him. I will have all of his CC linked in a Google document in the description. And yeah, so thank you guys so, so much for watching. If you enjoyed this video and you would like to see more content like this, please give me a thumbs up, leave a comment down below letting me know, or subscribe to my channel for more content. I hope you're having a wonderful, wonderful day, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye!